Hello, children. Hello? Hello, children. Can you hear me? Say something, write something. Hello, Victor. Hello, Inaui. Can you hear me? Tell me something. Hello, Candela. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Tell me something. Yes? Victor, are you okay? Inai, are you okay? English, please. Hello, Candela. How are you? Okay, so that seems to work. So now, please, we're going to start our broadcasting mission at 10 o'clock. Okay, so you have some minutes to talk with yourselves, okay? And please, all you got to have in mind is that you need your notes, your social science notes, and be very attentive. Hello? That seems to work. Good. Hello, Diana. Hello, Fran. English, please. Hello, how are you? We're going to start. Are you ready? Are you? Good. So stop taking part in your chat, okay? Stop. Good. So pay attention now, because we're going to start our class. It's our first class online about social science, and we need to finish this theme. And there is just a few things we need to know about our history. So we're talking about our recent history, about the history of Spain, and we did many exercises about the Spanish Civil War, and now this is some notes about Franco's dictatorship. As you know, Franco won the Spanish Civil War, and from that moment on, in 1936, a new period in the history of Spain began. Okay, and this period was a very difficult period for many people in Spain. Okay, because you have to bear in mind that in the aftermath of the Spanish Civil War, many people that lost the war were forced to go into exile. Many of them went to France, and they were gathered in concentration camps in France. And after that, the World War, the Second World War, started, and very soon Hitler, Adolf Hitler, took over France, and many Spaniards that were in the concentration camps were sent to other concentration camps in Germany, Poland. So those were hard time for those people that lost the war in Spain, that were supporting the Republic, were supporting democracy. Okay, and many other people had to go to other countries, such as United Kingdom, and a lot of them went to American countries, especially Argentina and above all Mexico. Okay, so that was the situation. The first years of Franco's dictatorship were very, very hard, because Spain was a very devastated, really devastated country. Okay, and in Europe there was a new war, a terrible war. Okay, the World War II, and for the Spanish people that were left in Spain, the situation was very, very hard. Okay, and in the middle of all of this, Franco was the man in charge. Okay, he was the dictator, and he set up our regime based on some things. And you have here the three pillars, the three superpowers where Franco based his dictatorship. One of them was the army. So imagine you are a dictator and you got power because by dint of force. Okay, so you want to keep this power, and you have to control the military, because the military men are the men that can carry weapons. So you need to control the military men, and he gave them a lot of power. Okay, and these are some traits. Okay, so many military men, especially high ranks, had a lot of privileges. Okay, and they have a very great authoritas. Okay, over the people in Spain, and the ideology was to the defense of the unity of the nation. And what does it mean? So first thing, no regional autonomy. You remember that at the end of the Second Spanish Republic, some regions got their autonomy. You remember Catalonia, you remember the Basque Country, and even Galicia. Okay, there were three, they are called the historic territories in Spain. Okay, and Franco banned all autonomous regions in Spain, so Spain was only one. Okay, and according to that, the only language that could be spoken there was the Castilian Spanish. Okay, and this is not a very important thing for people that live in Madrid, in Andalusia, in Extremadura, but this is very important for if you are a Catalan, you are a Basque, or you are a Galician. Okay, so the only places where they could speak Catalan, Galician, or Euskera were inside their homes. Okay, so this is important. The second pillar was the Catholic Church. The Catholic Church sided with Franco's side from the beginning. And if you are a dictator, you need something that can be used as the tool to I don't know how to say in English, but you need something that can say this is the man in power because of something very important. And the Catholic Church gave Franco support, and Franco was considered the man in charge because of God's will. And the Catholic Church played a very important role in this part. And in exchange, Church was allowed to control social life and education and the moral code. Remember that in the Spanish Second Republic there was a divorce, okay? But this divorce was banned during the dictatorship, okay? The only religion that could be practiced in Spain during the dictatorship was the Catholic religion. So you were a Muslim person or a Jew or a Protestant, you had a lot of problems to practice your religion. And another trait was that the church imposed with Franco a vision of the Spanish past. So things such as the Reconquest, the Spanish Empire, and the Catholicism were felt as the true traits of the true Spain. Okay, very good. And finally, you want to rule a country, you need to fill many posts, okay, many offices in Spain, because you have to think that there are many cities, many towns, many little towns, and you need councillors, you need people that can control things everywhere, okay? So you need a party, and the only party that was legal at the moment was Falange. If you didn't belong to Falange, you had problems, okay? Let alone if you were a communist, you were a socialist, or you were whatever, okay? You could go to jail and be behind bars. And so Falange was the only party in power. And Franco was the chef of Falange, was the boss of Falange as well, okay? Falange is a party that I think it exists still in Spain, and has fascist traits with the symbology, with uniforms, political violence. They practice political violence, especially in the first years of the dictatorship. And if you didn't belong to the Falange, if you belong to another party, you faced hard things, okay, persecutions, incarceration, and in many cases death penalty. Many people died in the Franco's jails, okay, especially the beginning of the dictatorship, but not only the beginning, okay, even in the end, okay. So 2 months before Franco's death, some people were shot dead, okay, some months in 1975. Okay. So life under Franco dictatorship was very hard, as I am saying. And another thing that is very important for the development of things in Spain was that in Europe, in the war, a new war broke out. Okay, the World War II, and Spain declared itself neutral. You remember that in the first World War, Spain declared neutral as well, okay? Those times the king was King Alfonso XIII, but Franco declared Spain neutral, okay? Despite the fact that he was friends with Mussolini and especially Hitler, okay? Very good. And as a result of that, Spain suffered continuous international isolation. Okay, okay. But this isolation was weakened. Okay, over the years. Why? Because the United States that won the war along with France and the United Kingdom found another very important enemy, okay, the Soviet Union. They were communists, and as Franco had fought against communists, he really fought against the democracy, but he fought as well against communists. They set up thinking that Franco could be their friend, and as a result, new agreements, new deals between the United States and Spain began. Okay, and as a result, as well, things start changing in Spain. Okay, and people experimented in Spain a new situation. Okay, little by little. And but this was not general, okay? Because many people in Spain that wanted a new life, they couldn't find it in Spain, and they start going abroad. So a new wave of migrants, Spanish migrants, start appearing, in especially in Europe, but not only in Europe. So many people from Spain went to countries such as France, such as Germany, Switzerland, United Kingdom, okay? Not only that, many of them were to Argentina, Mexico, okay? So Spanish migrants were very important in those years. We're talking about the 70s, and the beginning of the, the 60s, the beginning of the 70s. And if you are a migrant, you are a very good thing for two countries. One, your country of origin and your destination country. If you are a migrant, you are a Spanish migrant, you go abroad, you are not asking for services, public services. So you are a very good thing. And if you go to Germany, imagine France, whatever, you want to work, okay, and you can accept living conditions that are harder than the people that live there. You can work for less salary, okay, and not only that, you are helping the economy of the new country of Germany in this case. Not only that, you go there because you want to make money, and the money you make, you are sending it to Spain. So as a result, you are a very great bargain for the two countries, because in Spain they had less people to ask for services, okay, and not only that, but also they have money that came from abroad, and this helped the economy. Okay, so when you see migrant people in Madrid, in Spain, you have to think about that, because Spain is a country that knows a lot about migration, because our ancestors, our family, many of them were migrants in many other countries. Okay, very good. So this is what happened there, and over time things start going better and better, and something appeared. So as Spain was a dictatorship, and was apparent tranquility in Spain, many people came here to do tourism. Okay, so tourism turned into one and maybe the most important economic activity. Okay, from those years to today. Okay, to today, and when tourism appeared in Spain, things start accelerating the change. Okay, because in Spain many people saw people that came from abroad with other habits, with other mentality, and things start changing a lot in Spain. Okay, meanwhile, in 1970, Franco that was worried about the continuation of his regime, appointed the Prince Juan Carlos as his successor. Okay, and the final years were terrible because in Spain, especially young people start revolting very near the school, very near Asunción Rincón and the university. Many people were revolting against the regime, young people, students, university students, okay? And not only that, but also some groups from the far right to the far left were practicing terrorism in Spain. So the situation was very, really terrible, okay? And finally, Franco died on November the 20th of 1975. So this is the text that you have there written, and now I'd like you to go to the exercise part, okay? And in your exercise part, you have here the exercise part. I'd like you to do it with you, okay? So be attentive. We are now in the exercise part, okay? 11, okay? Number 11. So, and first question is, the three pillars of Franco's dictatorship were, and you have A, charge, political parties. Political parties impossible, okay? Because they were banned. So, A can't be. B, the army, the unions. The unions, impossible, because they were banned. Okay. C, the church, the army, and the Franje. Yes, this is the right. So C is right. 11.2. Official languages in Spain during Franco's dictatorship were, and if you have the Castilian, the Euskera impossible. Okay. B, Castilian, the Euskera impossible. Euskera impossible, Catalan impossible, Galician impossible. The only legal language that could be spoken in Spain and studied in Spain was the Castilian Spanish. Okay, so D is the correct answer. 11.3. As to autonomous regions in Franco's dictatorship, autonomous regions. So Catalonia, Andalusia, no. B, autonomous regions were not tolerated. B is correct. Okay, we don't need to look at the other two choices. 11.4. The political power in Franco's dictatorship was all in Franco's hands. Okay, this is the correct answer. Okay, this is the correct answer. 11.4, the correct answer you have here, was all in Franco's hands, because B is impossible, dependent on elections. There were elections, okay, in Franco's dictatorship, but were elections that were manipulated, okay? They said, okay, what is the difference between a democracy and a dictatorship? And they thought, because in a democracy they can choose people, okay, we're doing the same. Okay, and this, the people that can be chosen, both the electorate, but the constituents, is the people that we want to be elected. Okay, they were manipulated. Good. So, and parliament. Okay, no power in the parliament. There was a parliament in Franco's time. Okay, but with no power at all. And judges were appointed by Franco and Falange. All these kind of things. 11.5. So, the Falange was a political party very similar to a socialist? No. A communist? No. Liberal? Impossible. A fascist party. Okay? Good. Now, 12. Answer the question. 12.1. What position took Spain during the World War II and why? Position was that these are decalage between my words and your and your chat, okay, about 20 seconds. So what position took Spain during the World War II and why? Can wait. Can anybody tell me? 12-1. What position took Spain during the World War II? Neutral. Very good. Very good, Santi. Neutral. Why? Because Spain was devastated. Okay. And Franco thought that the best thing for Spain was not to take part in the war. Okay. 12-2. Which two facts broke the Spain's isolation in the world? The two facts were first, the help of the United States to Franco, and second thing, as a result, the economic help from the United States, okay? And that sets out the importance of the economy mainly based on tourism. Good. So, and 12-3, when did Spain start changing its economy? During Franco's dictatorship. We are now in 12-3. When did Spain start changing its economy? When? So, in the 1960s. In the 1960s. Okay? Before were really hard times for Spain. Many people couldn't eat, okay? And there were large flocks of people that were looking for food, okay? Very good. So, 12-4. Who first thought of Prince Juan Carlos as the king of Spain? Who was the man, who was the person that start thinking about the Prince Juan Carlos as the future king of Spain? Maybe a party, a political party? Maybe his father? No, the person that first thought about Prince Juan Carlos as the king of Spain was Franco, okay? And he was appointed by Franco. That's why he was the king. Good. And finally, 12. Yes, you're right. 12-5. Why the final years in Franco's dictatorship were so difficult? Because many people on Franco's side thought that the best thing was to change the regime. Another reason was because especially young people wanted democracy in Spain. Another reason was that there were violence, political violence from the far right. Okay, this is sometimes people forget about the far right in Spain, and they played a very important role, okay, a very violent role, killing a lot of people, and on the other side as well, okay, in the far left, okay, especially with the group ETA, that killed a lot of people, okay, during the final years of the dictatorship. And now we're finishing this part. Go to the 13.13, and you have to complete this timeline. And there, you have six dates. So, this is 1931. And 1931 is important, not because the king went into exile. The important thing is that that very year, in 1931, in that very year, a new regime started in Spain, the Second Spanish Republic. So 1931 is the year when the Spanish Republic, the Second Spanish Republic, was born. In 1936, these are very important dates in the history of Spain. 1936, that was the year when Franco revolted against the Republic, okay? And the Spanish Civil War began. Next date, 1939. This is important. This is the year when the Spanish Civil War ended, okay? Finished with the victory of Franco's side. 1917, important in the history of Spain, because this is the year when Franco appointed Prince Juan Carlos as his successor. Okay? Good, good. Now, 19... Yes, you're right. You're taking part. Very good, very good. Very good. 1975. Another year that you can forget in the history of Spain, because that was the year when Franco died. Okay? So 1975. And 1978. What happened? 1978. I'm not talking about Franco dictatorship anymore in this year. We're talking about something new. Okay? A new regime we are living in today. So this is the year. This is the year 1978, when the democratic constitution was approved, okay, first by a referendum, okay, by all Spanish people, and then the new parliament. Good, good, very good. Now this is our theme for today, and now I'd like you to watch some very beautiful words that some of your mates sent me. So it's right here, because this is a very interesting work that Maria, your mate, our friend, sent me, okay? And I want to share with you. So this is Pablo Picasso. Pablo Picasso is one of the most important painters in the history of Spain. And for some people, he ranks along with Velázquez and Goya as one of the best painters, not only Spanish painters, but painters in the world. And Maria did this important, this interesting work, okay? So, and Maria has to take care with her spelling, okay, a little bit. But what is important in this information? That he was Spanish, that he was in Malaga, okay? He was a young man when the Spanish Civil War erupted, okay, broke out. Okay, this is important there, and these are some of your paintings. Okay, this is El Picador Amarillo. Okay, you want to know anything about El Picador Amarillo or Picadores, you need to know about bullfighting. Okay, I don't know if you like or not bullfighting, but this is the people that are on horse back, and he drained the bull of his strength before the bull fighter starts killing him. Okay, good. So, but the important thing is the color. Okay, this yellow color that dominates the entire canvas. Okay, because here this is yellow, and here this is brown, and brown has some yellow in it. Interesting. Another portrait is this. This is Retrato de la Tía Pepa. Okay, this is another different stage in Picasso's career. Okay, interesting. You like it? This this painting is called La Habitación Azul. Okay, so this blue color dominates the entire canvas. Okay, all of it is full with blue. Interesting, very interesting. And now another painting in this blue color is that El Viejo Guitarrista Ciego. Okay, if you are concentrated enough, maybe you can even hear the strings of this guitar. Okay, good. And this is another interesting canvas painting. This is called Las Señoritas de Avignon. Okay, Avignon is the name of a French city, but in this case Avignon is the name of a street that you can find even today in the center of Barcelona. Okay, and these señoritas are women that are waiting for clients. Okay, there was a bar, okay, a club there in this city, in the street, Avignon Street, and Picasso maybe saw them, okay, at the door. Okay, this is important because this is the first painting with a new style. The style is cubism. Okay, good, Señoritas de Avignon, but maybe, without any doubt, the most famous painting by Picasso was the Guernica. Guernica, you remember we talked about the Spanish Civil War. Guernica was that Basque town that was virtually obliterated by the aircraft, by the German aircraft, Hitler aircraft. Okay, Hitler was Franco's friend. Okay, and you can see first that the painting is in black and white, okay, no color, okay, no joy at all, okay, all is horror. And you can see here a mother with his kill son, okay, and here people that are dementating. You can hear this horse, okay, this horse and this bull is the symbol of the country of Spain. Okay, people surprised, they can't believe what they are seeing here. Okay, people in flames as a result of the bombing of Guernica. You can enjoy this magnificent painting in Madrid, in Reina Sofia Museum there. Okay, it's a very large painting. Good, very good. And I wanted to show you another presentation. In this case, this is a presentation that was sent into me by Nico, okay, and about Salvador Dalí. We have two presentations about Salvador Dalí. One of them is this. Okay, Salvador Dalí was another very famous Spanish painter. He was friends with Federico García Lorca, with Buñuel, in a place in Madrid that was called, and is called, and it is still exists today. It is called Residencia de Estudiantes. Okay, it's. To understand well Salvador Dalí, we have here some. Okay, so you have to know some things. So he was a Catalan person. Okay, he was born in Figueres in Girona. Okay, good. And he died on January. Okay, good, very good. In January 1989. Good. And he was not only a painter, but also as a designer, writer, not very important writer, but as a designer. Think about lollipops. Lollipop was a Spanish invent, okay? And he was called Chupa Chup, okay? So the logo of Chupa Chup was invented by Dalí. But the important thing about Dalí is not that. The important thing is his artwork. This particular painting, I don't recognize as a painting by Dalí. So we're moving to another one. Some famous paintings are. This is interesting. This is called The Persistence of Memory. And this painting has a lot to do with the new theories about relativity. This is a very complicated thing, okay? Relativity. And that means that time is something different from what we tend to think about that. That's why you can see here some clocks, okay, bending, okay. You don't know about time at all. Bending. Take a look at this bay. This bay is Urquigat, okay, very near Figueras and very near Calaques in Girona. Okay, good. So next painting. This is Muchacha la Ventana, and she is his sister. This is Dalí's sister. Now, more things that we have here. This is Retrato de Mae West. Mae West was an actress, okay? And it seems like a portrait, okay? If you look into it, you can see that these are curtains, and this is a room. You look closely, this is a sofa, a chimney. These are not eyes, look like eyes, but they are paintings. Okay, so all in all, looks like a portrait of this then famous actress. And finally, I recommend you to go there to visit this place in Figueras, okay? These are eggs. Eggs, okay? Here inside you can see a lot of paintings by Dalí, okay? And another work about Dalí was sent yesterday to me by Diana. This is interesting as well, okay? We have here some notes about Dalí, but we can read them. And we have more paintings. This is another very famous painting by Dalí, a very famous, okay? He painted this Christ, okay? From a very different angle. The one we're used to, okay, and this is again the same bay as before, Port Lligat, very near Calaques, very near Figueras in Girona. Can you see it? Okay, good. Okay, we have here the same painting as before, and here we have another painting. Dalí is interesting because he belongs to a movement that is called Surrealism. Surrealism is the world of dreams, okay? Dreams. So you spend half of your time living in vigil, okay? Woken, okay? And the other half you are sleeping, and you are alive when you are sleeping. And when you are sleeping, there are many things that happen there that are not real, but happen. Things that are not real, but things that are happening. And they said, the surrealist movement said, okay, if they are happened, we can represent them. And okay, and in this case, what can we represent? And they said, our dreams, okay, we can imagine. And you can see here, this is a pomegranate. And here, maybe you can see, a bee, okay? And a bee. And as a result, this woman is dreaming of these tigers, of this elephant, this very strange elephant. Okay, this is surrealism. And this is another painting. Okay? You look here up, you can see a landscape. Okay? Another time again, the bay of Portugal. Okay? A landscape. And here you can see swans. Okay? But you look this down part, you can see swans, you can see elephants. Can you see them here? Elephants. Okay? This is like a dream. This is realism. That's why this is so interesting. Okay? That is another person you have to be proud of. Okay. More things about surrealism. Okay? They look a half elephants and a half spiders. Okay, spiders with not 8 legs but just 4. Can you see them? Okay, this is not real. This is a scene that belongs to a dream. Okay, so good. Again, the same movement. Okay, so this is a saint. That is on the verge of being stepped by this horse. Okay, this horse is the first horse in a procession of elephants. Okay, of elephants, a terrible procession. Okay, in the desert. Okay, very good, interesting. Art is very interesting. Okay, this is a canvas of a painting about a mythological character that was called Narcissus. Okay, Narcissus was so beautiful that all people here wanted to be with him. Okay, but he rejected them because he was in love with himself. Okay, with himself, and as a result, he died. Okay. He start looking his face, okay, in the surface of the water, and finally he fell down to the water and drowned there. This is the Greek mythology about Narcissus. There are some paintings here. We're finishing it. This is the same as before, not exactly the same. Okay, this is a variation. I didn't know this variation, but these are clocks. Okay, time. Remember, this is the bay of Portugal, very near Figueras. Okay, and looks like a bay, but this is a sheet. Okay, a blanket. Okay, good, very good. This is another painting about bullfighting. Look this image here. This is not a woman. This is a bullfighter, and this bullfighter is turning into a woman. Okay, this is the Venus of Milo. Okay, a very famous Greek statue. And this is a Colosseum, but this is a bull ring. Okay, good. Now, that's another painting, a religious painting. This is Jesus Christ, and this is the Last Supper. Okay, the Last Supper, there were 12 disciples, and here you can count 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so interesting. And again, the bay in the background. Can you see it? The bay, okay, the bay of Portugal, very near Figueras. So he was very fond of this bay. Of this landscape, of his Catalan land, and this is the last painting, and this is surrealism, pure surrealism. Okay, looks like a man, looks like a leg. Okay, here you have another person, maybe this is a woman, we don't know for sure. Very good. Well, that's all. We don't have time to finish that, we have to rest a little bit, and you got to stand by, go there, and you want to drink, you want to go wherever you want, and we are seeing, we're meeting in just 10 minutes, okay? I'm going to put the computer when there is 5 minutes to 11, okay? Very good. I hope you like it. Good. Bye-bye.